Imagine the sunlight coming up from a window that woke you up at morning. According to quantum physics, this light is made up of tiny particles called photons streaming through air. But what is exactly photon, and what is responsible for, and what is the history about photon? Everything you know about this in the full video.
Here we go. We have two types. The first type is absorption, and the second type is emission. These two types both have a nucleus. This may look like a ring, and they are the way that electrons move. The first ring is the lowest energy level. The next ring is the lower energy level, while the third ring is the excited state. In the first type, that is absorption, this orange circle is an electron. The electron is moving from the lowest energy level to an excited state. While moving, incoming photon is absorbed by the atom. And here, the photon is going from the lower energy level to the excited state. And incoming photon is absorbed by an atom. In the second type, we have emission. The electron is moving from the excited state to the lower energy level, and the lower energy photon is emitted. While here we have electron is moving from excited level to the lowest energy level.
Wave particle duality. Let's go back history. This theory assumes that both matter and light appear by the properties of waves and particles at the same time. It is self-evident for everyone who studied physical principles that matter has particle properties because it is composed of atoms and particles. And that light has a wave nature because it is formed and frequencies certain. But quantum mechanics, that means in the modern physics, has shown that the particles sometimes exhibit the properties of particles depending on the type of experiment being tested. In the 16th century, Christian Huygens and Isaac Newton assumed two theories. Huygens believed that the light is a wave of nature, and Newton believed that the light has the properties of particles. Due to the lack of observations supporting Huygens' theory and the Newton Science Center, the scientific community supported Newton's theory and worked on it for centuries. But at the beginning of the 19th century, scientists noticed the phenomenon of light diffraction, refraction of light when colliding with an object, which scientists had difficulty explaining in light of Newton's theory. And one scientist, Thomas Young, presented the famous double hole experiment. The scientist's eyes turned again for Huygens' hypothesis. In 1905, Einstein published a paper explaining the photoelectric effect, in which he described light as an energy represented by what is known as a photon. And in light of the existence of experiments and observations, one of which confirms the wave nature of light and the other confirms the particle nature of the light, scientists recognized the double nature of light according to the type of experiment. Just like light, scientists have found that matter has a double as well. Scientists have noticed that very large objects emit wavelengths so short that they can be considered non-existent. And therefore, there is nothing to distinguish them as waves, and they can be considered of a particle nature. Either in case of very small objects, such as electrons, we notice that they have very large wavelengths, that we can consider it like a wave. And here it appears, the wave nature for matter.
To start, we now will calculate some equations related to photon and its energy. First of all, we have in the first question, find the energy of a photon if the wavelength is 5 meters. To calculate the energy of photon, either Planck constant times the frequency, if the frequency is given, or the Planck constant times the speed of light divided by wavelengths. Here, the frequency is not given, so we use the second way. Energy equal the Planck constant, which is 6.626 times 10 to the power negative 34. Times the speed of light. Divided the frequency, which is 5 meters. Let's go now to the second question. Find the wavelength of a wave traveling at 20 meters per second at a frequency of 5 hertz. To calculate the wavelength either the speed of light divide the frequency or the Planck constant times the speed of light divide the energy of the photon. Here we use the first step, which is the speed divide the frequency, and the answer is 4 meters. Now let's go to the third question. If we want to calculate the momentum of a photon, we don't use the momentum equal mass times the velocity. We use the momentum equal Planck constant divide the wavelengths.